Facebook and Instagram ads are one of the best ways to get your desired reach, leads, and conversions. But there is one mistake that most digital marketers make while running Facebook ads, due to which they lose thousands and thousands of rupees. And today, I'm here to talk about how not to make that mistake. My name is Puneet Tandon, this is Young Urban Project, and today I'm talking about Facebook ads. Targeting is one of the most important aspects of a Facebook ad. When you do it right, your ad can do wonders. But when you do it wrong, you can lose a lot of money. Before talking about that, let me talk about three types of audiences that you should be aware about. The first type of audiences, the warm audiences. These are the people who have visited your website or are already aware about your business, your products, your services. So it's safe to say that these are the people who have the highest probability of converting into your audiences. The second type of audiences, the lukewarm audience. Now, this could include your lookalike audiences. Now, the lookalike audience is the extended audience that, according to Facebook, behaves very similar to your warm audience. Now, they might not be as relevant as your warm audience, but there's still a possibility that their behavior would be similar, their interests would be similar, and there is a slight chance or even a high chance of them converting into your customers. The last type of audience is called the cold audience. Now, this is the largest set of the audience. These people are probably not even aware about your product or your business. Now, the cold audience becomes extremely important, especially when your product is new. Since your product or service is new, you don't have any warm audience. And that's why you need to go after the cold audience. And that is where targeting will make all the difference in your ad campaigns. Now, let's take an example. Let's say you want to sell gym clothing or athleisure to online audiences, and you want to use Facebook or Instagram ads for that. How most people would set up a campaign is they would select an audience, say, I want 22 to 45 year olds, both men and women, and they are interested in workout, and they would start the campaign just like that. Now, don't get me wrong, it might work for some people, but it might not be the most effective way of targeting people. Because your audience is very layered, their interests and their behavior is very layered. And that is why your targeting also needs to be layered. The more understanding you have about your audience, the better your targeting would be. Try to answer some questions. What does your audience, which might become your customers, what are they interested in? What do they like? What do they not like? What are the kind of brands they are interested in? What are the kind of magazines that they read? When you answer these questions, you will be able to refine your targeting to a great extent. I know, a lot of you must be thinking, but hey Puneet, how do we do this? Do we have to buy a new tool for this? Do we have to shell out money? Don't worry, I'm going to show you how to do this right from Facebook's Ad Manager for free. That's true, this is one of Facebook Ad Manager's best kept secrets, and I'm going to show you how to use that. So let's get right into it. To start, let's get inside Facebook and then come to this shortcuts section and press see more, and when you scroll down you'll see the ad manager here. Click on the ad manager and your ad manager will open here. So come to this place where it says business tools and click it. When you click it, just scroll down and come to this section called audience insights. Click on this. When your audience insight opens, it'll ask you to choose between an audience. Just select the first one, which says everyone on Facebook. And now, this is where you can find your audience insights, you can find your relevant audiences. So the first section here is called location. It says United States. I'm just going to X this and cross it out because I want across the world. I don't want just United States. And this is where you fill in your interests. If you look at this section, this is where it'll show you the demographics. This is where it will show you the page likes, which means what pages does your audience or the audience that you're looking for likes. So let's come here and write gym clothes, because this was one of our interests and this is what we are wanting to sell. Now this shows a cool insight that 78% of this audience is women, and most of this audience is between 18 to 24 and 25 to 34 years. Now, if we didn't know this, we would have just selected a 25 to 45 kind of an age group, but this is where we find out the granular information of what exactly, where exactly does the prime TG lies in. And you can find other information below, which is the education level or relationship status or the job titles. But what we are most interested in is the kind of interests they have, what are the pages that they like. So when we go down here, this is where it will show you the kind of pages this kind of an audience likes. You'll see a lot of the page names here like Body Sculpt, Touche Sports. So let's see more. And this is where you will find some kind of hidden gems that you might not have thought about. For example, Gymshark. Now, Gymshark is a gym clothing brand, and this is something that you could use in your list. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to write a little bit about my audience here, because this will help me while making the ads. Demographic, the age group of my audience was 18 to 34, mostly women. And now let me also write the kind of brands or, you know, other interests they have. So Gymshark is one. I can also see Adidas here. I can see Pretty Little Thing. Okay, so this is a women's clothing brand and I didn't know about this. So that's a great place to start. I can also add this one. So if you're sitting in a different country and you're kind of running ads for audiences in another country, this kind of an audience insight will help you a lot. Like I said, your audience is very layered. So one of the things you could do to refine this further is, you can just take up one of these interests that you found and now add that into the interest panel. Gymshark. I'm just gonna select this. Now my base interest is Gymshark, and you can see that there are more opportunities that you can now spot, like gym memes. So we're going to go further up again, and I'm going to write another interest here, which is athleisure. And let's see what we can find for that. You can see so many more opportunities here, which you can use in your targeting. So if we keep going down, I think we'll also find some magazines or some kind of publications these people are interested in. And here it is. Look at this. This is called the Shape magazine. Brilliant. So this is the Shape magazine. It talks about fitness, healthy eating, mind and body and weight loss and all that. So I think that's another great opportunity for us. So as you can see, I'm making a well-researched targeting list here, and this is going to help me make a laser-focused campaign. So I have got my demographics in place, I've got my interests in place, and based on these interests, I can keep making the list further. So one of the things that you have to remember is, whenever you are trying to create a campaign for cold audiences, your potential audience size has to be between 1 to 4 million. Too small won't help, too big would become very broad. So remember, you have to keep it between 1 to 4 million. So when you select the interests like these and the demographic like that, it'll be easier for you to reach at least 1 million. So if your potential audience size isn't coming into this range, you can keep adding more results into this list. So this is how the audience insight works, and this is how you can use it for your advantage to create extremely refined and well-targeted campaigns. I hope that you liked the video and found it valuable. If you did, can I ask you to like the video and drop a comment so I can read it? It would also be great if you can share this video with your friends who are interested in Facebook ads. If you would like to see more such content about digital marketing, please subscribe to Young Urban Project. I would love to have you as a part of this channel. Meanwhile, if you want to learn something more, check out this video. It's great. This is Puneet Tandon. I will see you next week in yet another video. This is Young Urban Project, signing off.